Hey guys, we're Evan and Caitlin.
And I forgot my name.
Bill and Britt from Punish Props.
And today we're gonna make the ultimate Nerf dart. Oh, dang it!
You weren't even close!
I'm out of ammo.
Oh, me too. I wonder if that works. How long have you been wanting to make your own Nerf dart?
I've tried in the past, and it didn't work.
Wait, what have we signed up for?
I have a better plan now. Getting the diameter just right so that it plugged up the barrel, but just loose enough that it would actually fire was kind of tricky. So the plan I think will work is to make it out of foam like they do for Nerf.
Check this out, ready?
Is that what we're gonna get? This kind of stuff?
Really squish it.
Oh, that's really squishy.
There's different densities. So we want to figure out which one we think is most Nerf-like.
Ah, foam!
So you're gonna make a design. We're gonna make a design.
Yep, and I want to 3D print the mold.
3D modeling first? Sweet.
To fusion!
3D modeling footage, everyone knows, is just so exciting to watch.
It's riveting.
I'm about to do something pretty cool.
Tell me when and I'll zoom in dramatically.
Bill has some thoughts.
Here's our dart. The tip will be silicone and the body will be foam.
Yeah.
So I want to make a mold for just the tip. And we'll cast it in silicone that's just this part.
Okay.
Then we'll have another mold that's the full thing. And I'll cast this, put it into the tip of the other mold, and it'll have a cavity for the foam. Cast the foam in behind it. Hopefully the foam will creep around and grab onto that so that they'll stick together.
And then it will be one.
So next morning, we're gonna see if our prints work.
Yeah. No running.
My action slide didn't work out. Oh my goodness!
Man, those look They're so purple. Shiny.
It really does look like a gummy treat.
That
it looks delicious.
Oh, don't eat that.
It goes
so we want this to
right
fit because we need to place these in here before we cap the foam.
Yeah.
Oh, Bill, check it out.
Yes.
Foam time.
While it's still pretty thin is when you want to pour it. Otherwise it won't flow in and around all our details.
It's already expanding. It's already expanding.
Oh, don't worry.
Maybe it won't be horrible.
It probably won't.
No! Oh,
no! Oh. Oh.
Yeah. Okay, well,
yeah.
Like, hey, whose fault was that? Bill, it was Bill's fault.
The good news is this feels like a Nerf dart.
Take two.
What?
That's a Nerf dart!
That's awesome.
Should we try it right now?
Try and shoot them?
Yeah.
Why not?
Do we have a modified gun
that without the thing
that,
in
that
it?
Doesn't have the thing?
We can make that happen.
Oh. Hey.
That's way easier. Let's just snip that off and keep the rest on. So we can use this for testing now.
Wiggle it like that.
The silicone seems fairly well bonded to the
foam.
Like that. I was expecting this to want to fall out, but it seems pretty well stuck to it. It's got some good weight on the end.
Yeah. My worry is that, like, I'm not sure if they're rigid enough.
I think Bill's is going to explode.
I have real high hopes for mine. I bet Evan's is gonna go end over end.
All right, so original first?
Original first.
I think the original's gonna do the best.
Ye of little faith.
Honestly, I agree. Mine's gonna flip-flop all over the place.
It's already flopping.
Original Elite Nerf dart.
Okay, so the real darts did pretty well, but it was time to put ours to the test.
My Nerf dart.
Moment of truth.
It fits really well.
Oh?
It does. There, locked, loaded.
Ah!
It took the whole thing with it.
Oh, it took the whole.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, it was too snug.
Okay, I'm gonna just mash that in there. Ready?
Did it? Oh, there it is. Okay, Lev.
I'm worried.
It came out!
It did better!
Nice try.
I think that's an improvement.
This is a mega gun, but I have an adapter to shoot the smaller darts, which is what we've been using. But the mega darts are 2.5 ounces, and that's about what mine weighs. So the weight, it's not the weight.
It's not the weight.
It's not the weight.
I think it might be too loose. It's gripped in there really well. And this one is not gripped. So I think that it should be about like 12 and a half. That is right.
Maybe we need a different type of foam.
We will have to do some more work.
Okay, so it's day two.
And this was a flopping failure.
Would you call it a flop?
Oh, I would call it a flop. It's too squishy.
And I think this hole down the real darts, when it fires, the air pushes on the back of where most of the weight is. So maybe we have to have a tube down the middle of it.
So we need to somehow add more rigidity and weight, but also have a hole down the middle taking out some of the rigidity and weight.
Yes.
Ooh, I wonder if we could do a test where we fill this hole and then fire it again and see if the hole affects it.
Okay, good test. Let's
there's a cat in my
Oh, it's just normal?
Normal.
I think this one is gonna work as well as normal darts do.
I think that the one filled in will actually not go as far because it's heavier.
I think that the filled Nerf dart is gonna outperform the hollow one.
Really?
Is that just since I said the opposite?
No, I think it is. I think that a little bit of weight will be good.
I think that Nerf actually figured out the right weight for their darts.
You think they know what they're doing?
All right, let's see.
Sorry, Bob.
Hollow center.
Oh!
Dramatically better.
Where's the modified one?
That doesn't clearly worse.
So you need the center hole for reasons.
For our next darts, we tried adding the hole down the center and compressing the foam with a plate to make it a little denser.
Here we go. Now time for the plates.
This isn't heavy enough. It started to push out.
I guess this is our life for the next 5 minutes.
So we had mixed results.
My rod popped out.
Ta-da! And whoa!
Oh, it is like
so official looking. It looks like a Nerf dart, slightly more rigid.
You're right, yeah, it is definitely not. Well, let's wiggle test. That's good news. That's really good news. It looks really good.
Who knows if it's gonna work? Predictions.
I think it's gonna act the same as before.
I think adding the hole to this one is gonna make a big difference.
Lock and load. This is my new dart that is filled and slightly more dense than the previous one. I think that was actually better than the first one.
My bullet with the hollow center.
Oh, bad.
Not great either.
I feel like if we keep refining our designs, we'll just end up with one of these.
It's so much more firm.
Oh, this feels really good. This feels like a Nerf dart. Yeah?
Ooh.
Yeah?
Shall we test them?
Yes. It's a little snug.
Why?
No.
No, come here.
So pathetic. So normal dart, this one is definitely a lot more dense, yeah. All right, so we may have to actually take a step back. Before, the less dense foam, we capped it so it would stay compressed.
Take four, we're gonna use the same foam and not cap it so it is not compressed.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let's shoot these guys.
Time engineering these darts to work with their blasters.
This is the fourth and final iteration. I'm hoping it at least leaves the barrel.
I think at this point, I realize what's going on. This will never perform.
We just made these!
It's definitely much more squishy.
Just snug enough. If it leaves the barrel, then it did better than that one.
I definitely think it's gonna fire. I think it's gonna be better than all of our past attempts. Mostly because we're just getting closer and closer to the actual Nerf design.
I'm gonna be optimistic and wear eye protection.
All right, here we go.
Yes!
Yes!
Woo!
Okay, should we try yours?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna aim at Bob, angle up 45. Oh! I almost hit him! Oh, throw him, throw back.
Yeah, after 4 days, that counts as a win.
You can make your own Nerf darts. It's 100% possible. So we succeeded.
Yay!
They just don't work well. Okay, so I thought that Nerf had this design to be safe. I was like, well, they're just limiting themselves, so we can just make it a lot better, right?
Turns out that Nerf has spent a lot of time engineering these darts.
Do you think the rifling made a difference?
No,
not even a little bit.
Not at all.
But I do think we got to try a lot of cool things with this, mixing silicone cast with a foam cast.
Using 3D printed molds.
Our darts are very pretty and durable.
I definitely want to try molds like this in the future.
Yeah. We made exactly what we designed.
Successful venture in prototyping.
Yes.
But I think what we really need is a few more brains on this. So if you guys have any ideas based on our iterations or maybe something completely different that you think would make for a better Nerf dart.
And I'm sure we can list all the materials we use.
Yeah.
We'll list everything we use below.
And if you guys want to learn more about casting, foam, silicone, why don't you guys tell them about your channel?
Punish Props Academy, we teach people how to make props and costumes, but specifically we have a whole series on molding and casting. You can find all that stuff over at punishprops.com.
And if you like this video and you want to support us so that we can make more videos, you can buy our awesome merch.
This is the epitome of this shirt. Oh my gosh. We made, then we failed, then we made, then we failed, and we learned so much through this process.
You can also check us out on Patreon. We do an after show after every video where we talk about behind the scenes stuff. We're about to record that now.
With us?
Yes, with Bill and Britt.
It's gonna be extra
special.
I feel
like it's gonna be very, yeah, it's gonna be extra special. Bye.
See ya.
No, I tried to, ah!
It's gonna drip. It's driven down the side.
Okay. These don't even wanna leave.
You shot me. Wait, what? Yeah. Sorry, Bob.
The orange one.
The orange one.
You didn't make any orange ones. I went to art school.